got Marth versus Korin. At least I hope it's Marth versus good. Marth versus Korin. Now, I've played this with Caleb before, and personally, I think Korin wins this matchup just because of the pure combo potential, and Marth can't do much against side B. But I think Marth can outmaneuver Korin and edgeguard Korin a lot better. Missing the tech on the Dolphin Slash. But if he can just be a little more aggressive with his edge guarding and not just shooting Dragon Fangs from mid stage, I think he could tie this up pretty quick. And Tipper Dragon Fang, I'm gonna tie that up.
Heal Bros!
Yeah, I'm just kind of lonely. Oh, I'm so lonely.
What's up?
Season chat. I don't know who X Viper is. Fortunate SD by Caleb. Alright, so that's 1-0 to silver. Let's see if Caleb stays Korin. And he has a Robin. The best Robin AZ. Okay. No. He's not going Robin. Even though I think that Robin versus Mark is in Robin's favor.
You actually won.
I know you. How do I get back on? Maybe this is grand finals and I have. Alright, going to town and city. Caleb, just like his name in the Tucson chat suggests, using a lot of side B.
Yeah.
Side B, side B, side B. Now, silver goes for a lot of these down throw up airs, but they're not true at all. That was ridiculous. So,
yeah, a lot of silver's game is a lot of retreating aerials and then just going for like reads off of throws.
Yeah, and it's like the read on the. Because I have a Marth secondary right now, so I'm just stunning. So, like, the DI mix-up on down throw is back air, if they DI away.
Right.
Since it's like Zelda's down throw, where they can only DI one direction. If they DI up, up throw won't work at all. So there's literally nothing that you can do all the way. But if they DI away, you can always get a timber back air.
Okay.
Yeah.
You saw earlier he perfect shielded the claw after dropping and perfect shielding
that was the shot. Yeah. Silver's movement is incredibly good. I just think that Caleb needs to be a little more proactive. aggressive with his edge guard.
Yeah.
Because he's dropping a lot of stuff. Even in his game against you, he was being very passive. And I know it's not just matchup and experience, because we've played this a lot.
Yeah. That's one of your favorite matchups to play with Mark. Because I can't imagine that playing a villager against Khorne would be very much fun with that range.
Yeah, I think that Khorne wins that matchup. Just because he can out-damage me. So I usually go Mario against Khorne. And my Mark is kind of like my Funzy character. Kind of like your Luigi. A couple more of these side Bs, and Silver's gonna be in kill percent. That's really good smash DI too.
Yeah, just jumping out of it. Oh, oh definitely. Oh,
with the
counter.
With the counter.
Yeah, that's one thing that he likes to do a lot is he likes to cover landing before smash or tilt. And he does it against everyone, it doesn't matter which character he's using, so it's really caught on to that.
Yeah, definitely.
Throughout the counter.
I mean, F tilt's not a bad option. It's really good, it kills decently early.
Right, but that's still, like, even safe. If he didn't F tilt instead of smash, he would have died.
Oh, yeah.
When you're playing against Khorne or Bayonetta or them, like, your normal things aren't normal anymore, and that's what you need to understand.
Yeah, your normal punishes just don't work.
Like, if you notice when I was playing my Mewtwo match, I was staying back on certain things because I was expecting the counter to come out.
Yeah, it's
and
not
even if it doesn't
true.
Come out, then you're still resetting neutral, so it's fine.
Yeah, and if it's like, not frame true, they can, Bayo can, like, air dodge or counter you out of it. And Khorne, you can counter you, and Khorne's counter is so good.
Yeah.
I just think that as this game progresses, I think Khorne's neutral is going to get fairly predictable.
Yeah, I agree.
Because side B is a good option.
It's still super safe, though.
It is super safe, but I don't think you will be getting as much damage out of it.
Fair enough. And shout out to Z for understanding my my salt there. My Mewtwo sadness.
Yeah.
But not even angry at Spearly, not angry at anyone. Angry at myself for letting it happen. It's in the game. But
tense
situation. And I knew it was coming. Like I knew it was gonna happen, like in the back of my mind, that entire last stock, I knew I was gonna get forward smashed at some point. And it just kinda happened.
Yeah.
And so like I was upset because I knew to look out for it and it still got me.
Khorne's F smash is nothing to us, nothing to sneeze at. I think it's about the length of what, like a tether grab?
Something like that. It's about 1/3 of Smashville, I believe. Which is ridiculous.
Yeah.
And honestly, you get hit by the inner part, you're not going to die anytime soon. But like you get scared of getting hit by it and you go out at a range and all of a sudden, boom, you're tipped.
Yeah. That's the scary thing about tip or hitbox is you don't want to go in because then you get hit.
But you also don't want to stay away because
that's
you get tipped.
Yeah. It's really unfortunate that Khorne has to rely so much on side B to neutral. Because her tilts aren't that good. Other than low percent combos, her tilts aren't that good.
That's true.
They all pop you up in a way.
But you don't always have to rely on side B. I mean, he does a lot of those little charge shots there, the Dragon Fang.
Yeah.
Or Dragon Claw. Dragon Claw, right?
I think it's like called Dragon Fang Shot.
Sure, that
but,
one.
But it's a claw.
Yeah.
It's realistically, it's a claw.
So you can side B and then you can be reverse the claw, and you can do a lot of things to just get away and play footsies.
Yeah.
And I think one of the things is like, yeah, they're very simple, but they're very safe, and it's a nice way to bait opponents into coming in. Nice way to just play your game and hold stocks. And so was Mark.
They're both this season right now. Because they can both
kill each other. Yeah, definitely. Dragon Fang Shot, Dragon Bite. I don't know, that's what Stroder is saying. Hi, Schroeder. Hey, Score, should you get your text message today? You know what I'm talking about. He knows what I'm talking about. Okay, I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh.
Now I know what you're talking about. I had to mute it so I could explain the Scorch text messages.
Yeah, because
we're
TSS and Scorch have a very interesting
relationship.
Text-based relationship.
I know Scorch likes it. Like, he pretends like he doesn't, but I know he does.
Oh! That dragon. Oh, damn.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh!
Yep.
Oh! Lots of screams coming from around AD, and none of them made any sense, but
good
that
stuff
is game
silver.
Two more weeks. Super Smash Bros. Who do we use?
Showing that Marth is the true hero king and can change fate. Shoutouts to Lucina.
Stop.